Hello there. Wow. Welcome back to Let's Play the Book of Unwritten Tales. Too blind. I'm the RPG chick. Pretty freaking obscure. What we have to do next to continue the storyline. Is this book about carpentry? Is a horror story for our ant friend over there? Arbor? So we can read it to the happy willow. I have no idea what's going to happen now. I just stopped the game because I saw that.
It's not nice, but I'll have to find out.
Why would we have to find out?
One can easily fell a tree with the help of an axe and wedges. In my experience, nothing beats a sharp saw guided by two men. Slish, slash! The teeth of the saw bite into the wood, and in a few minutes, even the largest tree tumbles to the ground.
Ooh.
After this, the smaller branches and the bark are removed from the trunk using hatchets. Once the tree is sawn into several pieces, it's ready to be transported away. Wow. I feel a bit dirty. It'll be all right. We'll see.
I want to look at this. You're making me dizzy.
The only thing I can say in my defense is that is what a weeping willow is meant to look like.
Right. Oh, there's a rainbow.
Hey, there's a rainbow.
I guess that's why it panned
Since
over.
Since the willow's branches are hanging down for some inexplicable reason. Mm-hmm. The sun is able to shine directly onto the waterfall again and is now producing a pretty rainbow over the garden. Others will judge whether it was worth traumatizing the willow for this, but the rainbow certainly adds a certain je ne sais quoi.
So you say, huh? Oh, look at the end of the rainbow.
Nate once said that rainbows never touch the earth. Wilbur wouldn't believe him. Let's see who was right. Nate once said that rainbows... Let's see who was right.
How are we going to see who's right? Look at the end
Nate
of the rainbow.
Once said that, let's see who was right. I don't know what I could ask him right now.
Ask about the rainbow? Dig? This is pretty freaking obscure, guys. Who would have thought this? We're gonna find our gold this way.
A pot of gold! And no grumpy leprechaun protecting it! What a stroke of luck.
Okay. I guess we have our pot of gold.
A pot of gold will be accepted anywhere as payment. It's a bit less than a pile of filthy lucre, but a bit more than a heap of dough.
A filthy lucre?
You're having a good time, I see.
Well, we have a reason to talk to him again.
What can I do for you?
I put your spade over there.
I don't need your spade anymore. I've put it over there.
I'm too lazy to go get it.
Ah, that's great. And you've dug a lovely hole, too, right in the middle of my lawn.
You're welcome.
Ah, sorry about that.
Oh, what the heck. I'll plant it with something.
I have to get on. Don't work too hard.
That I won't.
I don't know what I could ask him right now.
Okay, I guess we can talk to Cheep Cheep now that we got our pot of gold for the hippogriff. We're figuring out how to get a freaking hippogriff.
Hey, Cheep.
I've got the pot of gold. Can you take it to the stud?
I have the pot of gold here. Go on, take it to the stud. Oh, I realize it's too heavy. I won an arm wrestling contest against an orc warrior in Seastone with the help of a strength elixir. We could get something like that for you.
Hmm.
I'll be back soon, sheep.
How about if you have some sunflower seeds instead? Maybe that'll make you stronger. Of course, I have to go over there to do that. And then I don't do anything. Hello? Doesn't work.
Hey, sheep. I'll be back soon.
Alright, a little bugged. A little bugged.
Hey, sheep. Do you want a few worms? Yes, nice, fat, juicy ones. I really shouldn't tease him anymore. Cheap is a vegetarian.
Okay. I'm going to talk about bring a potion. One of our parents. Or maybe this guy?
I don't know what I could up.
Okay, never mind. We need to, like, move over here.
Pa?
Is there anyone else in this place except for me and my parents? And the ant? Hypothetically, if Cheep Cheep had to carry a pot of gold...
Hypothetically, if Cheep Cheep had to transport something heavy through the air, how could I help him do it?
You could ask me to give him the necessary strength. Which you have just done, have you not?
Well, yeah.
Really?
Of course. But the effect would not last long enough to transport you to, let's say, Seastone.
He doesn't need to do that. It's just a short distance.
All right, bring me some sunflower seeds.
I have those. Why do you need sunflower seeds?
What exactly do you want to do with the sunflower seeds?
You'll see. It will make Cheep Cheep strong enough to carry even a heavy load for a short while.
Okay, well, here are they. Here they are, blah, blah, blah.
I have a few sunflower seeds. Here.
Good. Keep still.
Keep still. Who's gonna stare him to death? What's that? Ooh.
That's it.
The hell?
Just give Cheep Cheep these seeds to eat.
They start spelling it right. Look at that. They start spelling it right. One half of the Cheep Cheep was spelled right. Have you cast a magic spell on these sunflower seeds? Duh.
Whatever you did to those sunflower seeds looked like magic to me.
Oh no! It was the opposite of magic. Nature. Life. Pure life.
Okay.
And what exactly do you mean by that?
Listen to the wind in the willows and the mole and the toad. They know the answer.
What does the fox say? See you later.
I've got quite a lot to think about.
Goodbye, little daughter.
See you later, father.
Magic sunflower seeds.
The sunflower seeds feel warm and they're vibrating slightly.
Hmm.
As if they were brimming with energy, just waiting to be released.
Maybe they're Mexican sunflower seeds. Mexican jumping sunflower seeds. Next sword. Okay. Just for the hell of it. Take these! Make you big and strong. Because I have to walk all over the place first.
Father's changed the sunflower seeds. Well, can you feel anything?
You're still eating them. Uh-oh.
Now don't exaggerate.
Okay,
here. Oh, I hope it works. What's he going to be like when he's super cheap?
Super cheap.
He's got enough of an exaggerated opinion of himself as it is.
Nah, we'll just have to put up with that. Super cheap, huh? Whoa. Ooh. Oops.
Oh, that's overdoing it a bit.
Is it what we need? Does it have a hippogriff in it?
I thought you just wanted to deliver the pot of gold. You deserve it.
Yes, muscles, I see.
Any problems on the journey? Good. And the watch just let you pass. Yeah, they trust you. I think Cheat might get used to having superpowers.
Well, that's gonna wear off soon.
I think Cheat might... It's really in there, is it? Our hippogriff? Why did the stud put it in there? Couldn't they have just let it fly back with you? You mean it was in the box already? You didn't actually see it? I'd love to have your trust. Oh well, at least it's pretty lively.
It's gotta be a pretty small hippogriff.
Cheap blind purchased the hippogriff. His trust in the Aculeus stud is far greater than his mistrust of humankind's capacity to deceive.
Okay. Just open
Relax,
it.
I'm on it.
What the hell? What?
You've still got the receipt, haven't you, Chief? Chief, didn't the hippogriff in the magazine look a bit different to this? Bigger, a bit more griff and a bit less hippo?
Bless you.
Is this the effect of the epidemic? Mother said it changed things.
We gotta make it super strong now.
You are strong enough, aren't you?
It's gonna work.
You were able to demolish that box just now. Can you carry me as far as Seastone? Right then.
Is this really gonna work? I love the rainbow rains.
Archmage, murdered by Wilbur Weathervane.
Right.
There's something strange afoot, Cheat. Mark my words. I don't believe a word of it. Someone's responsible for this epidemic, and someone wants to hurt our friends. Away to Seastone.
Oh. Working? Are we done with chapter one? A few days earlier in Seastone. Hey, it's our favorite Wilbur.
My name is Weathervane, Professor Weathervane.
Okay.
You want to teach us?
Oh, it's kids.
Well, yes. Why not?
Ugly kids.
You're a gnome. Gnomes can't do magic.
Except
I
for
can
me.
And have. During my mage training, Yes?
My mother also says that you should not be a teacher. But I think you're great, Professor.
Oh, thank you.
Say, Professor, what exactly is the magic constant? How long must Veritaserum mature?
Veritaserum.
Can you tell us about ancient magic runes?
I even know how to put a stopper in death. You seem to know a lot about magic.
You seem to really know a lot about magic.
More than you, anyway. Maybe we should switch places.
Maybe you should shut your... We never talk to teachers like that in my day.
Well, we do in mine. We'd like to have answers to our questions.
Be quiet and sit properly.
How about you sit down properly first?
No.
Nope. That's no professor. Or, more properly, yes, professor.
Nope means yes, professor. That's going to cause some misunderstandings.
Mm.
So, the magic constant? Veritaserum? Ancient magic runes? We want to learn something.
You're going to learn what I want you to learn. Unless you end up with, like this guy up here. I can answer all of that later.
I will answer all your questions, but not now. It's time for History of Magic.
Then I have a history question. As everyone knows, gnomes are completely incompetent when it comes to magic. To be exact, only one great gnome mage has appeared in the last 800 years.
Two now.
He defeated Grimmar, the last of the great dragons. What was the name of that last great gnome mage?
He was called, don't ask me stupid questions.
He was called, sit down at your desk properly and don't ask stupid questions.
But don't they say, there are no stupid questions, only stupid answers. And that there aren't supposed to be any bad students, only bad teachers.
Not the right time. Whatever I'm saying that for.
Not right now. We will open your textbooks to page
394.
So I was right, wasn't I? You know nothing, not even the name of the only great mage your own people ever produced.
I just need a drink of water. Frog in my throat.
She's annoying kids, man. Like, oh, to slap
man.
The hell out of them.
Master Marcus warned me that the students would test me the first few hours, but this is a nightmare. I don't know all these things. I know nothing. Easy, boy. Easy.
Yeah.
Think, Wilbur.
You're having a full-on panic attack. Hello, little rat thing. Rabbit sheep? Fridolin? Fridolin? The rabbit sheep?
This is Fridolin.
Fridolin. Okay.
I had to cast the transformation spell during my mage training. And this is the result. I think we make a good team. A young mage and his rabbit sheep. Fighting side by side as a force for good. Unfortunately, Fridolin doesn't do much other than lay in bed and eat. We still have to convince him it's important. Well, buddy? What are you eating there? Hey, that's my notepad. I might still need that notepad.
I don't bite you.
Hey, I thought we were a team. Fridolin gets pretty grumpy when he's hungry.
Which I guess is all the time.
He's always hungry.
Right.
I can't get to the notepad. And if I don't hurry, soon there'll be nothing left of it. I can't get to the notepad. Way I'm taking a bowl with me. I mean, how am I supposed to put a bowl of water into my pocket without getting my robe soaking wet? It's not like I can just carry anything around.
No?
But I could use the bowl here in the room. Do you want some water, Fridolin? He seems to be hungry more than anything.
That's a stove, okay.
The entire school building is a bit scary. No one knows exactly where it was the last 20 years. It disappeared overnight and then reappeared just as suddenly once the war ended.
Really?
There's a lot of magic in these old walls. The stove is always on, for example, and even though I've never put any wood in it. A magical stove is a fine thing in winter. But in the summer, this small room could quickly become sweltering.
So you haven't figured out how to turn the thing off, huh? Feel the heat.
Ow! That stone is definitely more than just warm.
Ear trumpet?
A beautiful golden ear trumpet. One of my predecessors must have laid it up there. A very tall predecessor.
Predecessor, huh. Is that one way of pronouncing it? Because I've only heard predecessor. Look at the bed.
The bed is pretty cozy. It's so cozy that Fridolin is curled up in it. But that's okay. Friends share. And he lets me sleep at the foot end.
He does, huh?
Earlier, in a situation like this, I would have holed up in bed and hoped that everything would somehow take care of itself. But those days are gone. I'm a professor of magic, and I have to solve my own problems. The bed is pretty cozy, but that's okay.
Teddy bear.
Teddy is just, a keepsake and some moral support from home. Soft and cuddly moral support.
So that's aviator glasses?
These are the aviator goggles that my granddad gave me before my first trip to Seastone.
Right.
Well, a pair of aviator goggles. The original pair was lost when Grandad fired me after the cannon. That's when I found out Grandad has a whole box of these goggles. Every time he tries to persuade some idiot to do something stupid, he makes a rousing speech and then hands over his old aviator goggles.
Right. Family photo?
My whole family stayed in the White Ridge Mountains. Why would they even want to come to Seastone? This isn't their world. Little Sydney can walk now and reach everything that's on the workbenches. That tripled her invention output. Maggie doesn't build battle robots anymore since the war is over. Now she's experimenting with computing machines. But Panda said there's no future in it.
Well, absolutely not. Computers are a dead cell.
Tell them I'm not an engineer, but a mage instead. Mum said she'd always suspected it.
Alright, I got some more stuff here. A wand, magic ball, magical contract.
Ah, my wand. The King of Thieves got it for me during my mage training. He and the other rats have been tirelessly helping to rebuild the city in recent months. They work closely with the Archmage, albeit mostly in secret. I still haven't figured out exactly how it works. Sometimes it performs the most amazing magic. Sometimes it can't even perform the simplest of tasks. Archmage Alistair's promised to have a look at it sometime. Maybe it has a loose connection or something.
Loose connection. Maybe you just need to practice, Wilbur.
Sometimes my wand works perfectly.
Capricious.
Sometimes less so. I don't quite have the hang of it yet.
That's a good name. The Capricious Wand.
Mages use balls like this to communicate over long distances. Master Marcus explained it to me. He'll know how I can tame those unruly students.
Well, let's use it in a minute. Let me just look at everything else in here first.
This is my contract, signed by the Archmage. I'm the first teacher in the School of Witchcraft and Wizardry. At least, the first since the school reappeared. At first, I didn't want to accept. I know almost nothing about magic. But Master Alistair said there are very few mages left, and I had completed mage training faster than anyone else. I was the right person for the job. I wanted to help and learn more about magic, so I agreed. Hopefully that was the right decision. I wouldn't want to disappoint Master Alistair.
Junk. And a magic set.
Like this before I ever moved in. Generations of teachers must have left this stuff here. I like it. The school has a history and when I have time, I'll rummage through it. A few of the crates and boxes are labeled. Hands off. Property of the Half-Blood Prince. Schrodinger. That box could hold a dead cat.
Right.
Or not.
Yeah. I've heard enough jokes about Schrodinger's cat, so that's a lifetime. Let's look at the magic set.
Master Marcus and the Archmage were so busy rebuilding the city that no one had the opportunity to teach me anything about teaching. This box was in a shop window down in the city. I thought it might be useful. After all, there are children with magic wands on it. But unfortunately, it just seems to be a bunch of those tricks. Like that old one with Mr. Wuppleman, the top hat, and the rabbit.
Right. From the first game. Oh, open.
Short white rope, a pair of dice, playing cards, and a guide on how to lead people up the garden path. That's just not right. Real magic or none at all.
Package of pet food. Oh, that's really good. That's what we need.
Fridolin might prefer green grass or fresh carrots, but all I could find in the city was this pet food.
Hmm. Oh, shoes.
This has to be the oldest shoe I've ever seen.
He might want to eat that.
This ability to stink. That's strange. There's paper in the bottom of the shoe. Oh, maybe the shoe has a hole and the paper is supposed to protect the wearer from getting wet feet. It's a sheet from a book. It's folded in the middle and printed on both sides. That equals 4 pages. It wasn't torn out. It looks more like the glue weakened than the sheet fell out. I'll just take it with me. Folded sheet from a book. A total of 4 pages were printed on it.
Let's read it.
I don't know what kind of book it is, but I should keep my eyes open for more pages.
You're kidding me. We kind of collect pages? What is this? Slender Tales?
A folded sheet from... I don't know what...
Lure him away with the book page?
I'm not sure Friedling would prefer this paper to that in my pad. Besides... I might still need the book page for something.
The hell would you need it for?
Okay, we'll do it like this. I'll give you some delicious pet food, and you give me my notebook back. Okay, buddy?
I don't think he likes the pet food.
Okay. Now give me my notebook, please. Hey, we'll get a deal.
I didn't see that coming.
I can't get to the notepad. I've thought a few times about I should try to fully transform Friedlin into a sheep or back into a rabbit. He seems to be quite happy the way he is. And I'm afraid that I might accidentally transform him into an elephant or a skunk or a dog.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's look in the crystal ball. The magic ball. It's a number? Was he dialing something?
I can't remember Master Marx's number. I had it written in my notebook.
Give me that notebook.
I can't get to the notepad.
Anything else? Magic wand on that. What am I going to use the water with? Huh. Okay.
I've thought a few times, but it seems...
Maybe you should just do it now.
Okay, fine. One more time. I'll give you proper food, and you give me my... Ouch! Okay, fine. And now... You can't always just take it a friendship, you know?
I don't think this is actually a friendship.
You want some water, Friedelin? He seems to be hungry more than anything.
I wish I could read these pages. Well, I don't know. We might need an item back in the classroom to fix this problem. And I'm sure there's going to be plenty to look at in there and students to interact with and stuff. And we're just over a half hour. So let me do that next episode. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bang, bang, boogie, and don't stop the boogie.